The workshop was a cluttered mess, authorities finding sewing equipment only meters away from bunk beds. At another sweatshop, investigators found worn mattresses, unsanitary conditions, and all kinds of fire hazards. A human rights group says 21 mostly migrant workers live there, working shifts of up to 16 hours under conditions of slavery.
These images show these places were in a dreadful situation. There were loose cables, flammable materials, plenty of dust and overcrowding. They were really living there like animals.
Gustavo Vera is the director of La Alameda, a human rights organization in Argentina dedicated to fighting modern-day slavery. La Alameda shot this video after a police raid at three workshops and is using the images as evidence in a federal complaint against three clothing manufacturers, Zara, Iris, and Cara Cruz. There's no evidence that the companies own or directly operate the workshops, but Vera says there's definitely a link.
They found labels. They also found designs, which prove that all of these three workshops worked for Zara.
CNN requested interviews with all three companies. Cara Cruz said it has not been legally notified about the case, and it has no knowledge of any links with clandestine workshops. Iris and Zara have not returned our calls. Both Argentina and Spain are on holiday for Holy Week. But Inditex, the Spanish clothing giant which owns Zara, told Spanish newspaper El País that they're surprised and indignant about the complaint. "We have no knowledge of the facts and we don't know what they're referring to," Inditex said. "We have zero tolerance when it comes to situations like this. We regularly audit the 60 providers we have in Argentina." This is not the first scandal Zara faces regarding workshops where their clothes are produced. Back in 2011, the clothing manufacturer was fined $1.8 million by the government in Brazil after an investigation showed dozens of Bolivian and Peruvian migrant workers were producing clothes for the firm in conditions of slavery. After the scandal, the company said that Zara has unveiled a series of new internal and external initiatives to reinforce control over the production chain. Argentina has begun to crack down against trafficking. Last year, a series of unconnected raids against other companies, also in Buenos Aires, targeting 12 sweatshops, 23 Argentine and Bolivian nationals were arrested. 76 immigrants from Bolivia, who were forced to sew clothes around the clock, were liberated during the operation. Rafael Romo, CNN, Atlanta.